Okay, so another message is a WhatsApp message, and it reads, "Hello, I tested you on YouTube. I am Martin, but a Kenyan, not a Nigerian. I have a Peugeot 406 that I bought. It was really badly maintained, but all I have." I've been working on it. It has some strange noise when running. I thought it was belt tensioner pulley. But after changing it, there is no difference. Okay. So, for what I can understand here, we are hearing noise from that chamber. Around that auxiliary belt or timing chamber. So you change your, I don't know, it didn't mention whether it's the timing belt or auxiliary belt pulley or tensioner that you change. But you say you change something there and the noise is still there. Belt tensioner pulley. What do you mean by belt tensioner pulley? You are talking about the roller on the tensioner itself. No, the roller is actually part of the tensioner. Okay, for the start, it didn't mention which engine model because that would have helped to know what to advise. But from the picture, you attached the picture of your Peugeot 406 there, but I didn't see V6 badge on it. So our zoom is a four-cylinder engine. However, it's possible yours is also a diesel engine. If it's a diesel engine, I may not know the setup. I know these diesels, they also use a timing belt, not chain. So, my advice is, if you want to isolate where the noise is coming from, what to do is remove your auxiliary belt. Remove the auxiliary belt, then start the vehicle. If you start the vehicle and the noise goes away without auxiliary belt, now you know that, okay, it has to do with the things the auxiliary belt spins through the crankshaft pulley. And that is the power steering pump, AC compressor, and what else? Then those other two, like for EW engines, they have two rollers. One is attached on the tensioner, while the other one is independent on its own. The one that is independent is bigger. The roller is bigger, while the roller on the tensioner is smaller. That I'm talking about the auxiliary belt tensioner. So you have to. Do what I suggested by remove the auxiliary. As long as your battery is okay, it's well charged, remove the auxiliary belt, then start the engine. It's just like more than less than 5 minute test. In fact, a minute or two is enough to know all these things. Start the engine, it will start, and of course the battery light will stay on, don't worry about it. Once you connect the battery back, it goes off. So then you listen attentively to know if the noise will come back. So if it does come back while the engine is spinning without the auxiliary belt, now you know the noise is likely coming from the engine itself, not those accessories at that timing chamber, that's on the auxiliary belt area. The crankshaft pulley can be noisy as well. However, that's when it's faulty or about to fail. However, it usually make noise or the noise becomes louder when the auxiliary belt is on it. In fact, when there is load on it, and the load is most times is when you put on the AC. That's when the noise becomes louder. Without AC, the noise goes off or at least less, or when you accelerate, it may come or come up. So it depends on the kind of noise, because as the crankshaft pulley noise is different from every other ones. So because I didn't hear the noise, so I can't really tell. It's more like I'm guessing now. I don't know how the noise sounds. Then that's all. This thing I'm saying is, if the noise comes up with your zali belt off the engine, so you check the crankshaft pulley. Another thing about crankshaft pulley, for especially the EW engine, the V6 is, in fact, even the diesel, I believe will be the same. I'm not sure. Is if the crankshaft pulley is bad and is the source of the noise, you will see it wobbling. Once you start the engine, it will be wobbling like this. You look at it, just stand from the right side of the engine, right side of the vehicle, which is this side, then look down on that zali belt area, look down on the crankshaft pulley. You will see if the engine is running. If it's good, it will maintain a straight line, even though it's spinning, right? To maintain a straight line. But if it's bad, you'll see that it will be wobbling. It won't be steady, even though it's spinning, turning every other thing. But it will be shaking. Look as if it's shaking. Once you start doing that, it's about to give up. So in your case, that's what you need to do. If it's not wobbling, then that's not, forget it, that's not where the problem is. Then another thing to listen to is, you put your ear around the timing, because now the zali belt is off. You put your ear closer to the timing chamber, usually covered with plastic from the upper part to the lower part of the engine. What's it called? The noise is coming from there. I will advise you, remove that cover immediately, as quickly as you can. I'm not saying do it yourself, you are not technical. Find somebody, a mechanic or whatever, have to remove it. Because if the noise is coming from the timing belt tensioner, trust me, it's not going to benefit you if you eventually give up. Because this is a big warning sign if it's coming from there. Or if it's coming from the roller, the timing roller, is also a big warning to do something about it before that belt snaps or pulls out of the camshaft sprocket. So you have to put your ear to know if it's coming from there. Or it's also possible that the timing belt is rubbing on or part of the plastic that covers that housing. So you need to isolate all this and put your ear to know if it's coming from there. Well, depending on the engine, for example, the V6 and the EW12 GA4, they have a VTC, variable timing camshaft sprocket. Again, variable timing camshaft sprocket, that's VTC. That particular one usually is bigger than the exhaust. Yeah, it's bigger than the exhaust sprocket, exhaust camshaft sprocket. That's this VTC. So yeah, it can fail, and when it fails, it can be this noisy. I've had a case where, I think it was even a V6, the exhaust camshaft sprocket. The sprocket or the pulley where you put the timing belts cracked, and so it wasn't noisy, but because it cracked, it can wobble or stuff like that. So it depends on the cases. It can be different in the world depending on the crack. It can make it wobble and it can be noisy, but of course, if you continue like that, it could break off and cause damage to your cylinder head. So you have to check all those things. But if the noise is not coming from the timing chamber, it could be that your camshaft is gone. You said you bought the car, that in fact, from what you said, I could even see from the look of the car you posted. You attached the picture to my WhatsApp. From the picture, I could see the one when you first got the car, then you did some body work on the car. So from that first picture I saw, probably when you bought the car, that car was badly maintained by the previous user. But over here, we call such cars gula gula. So somebody that used a car and the body was in that state, You could tell that even the mechanicals and probably the electricals were in shambles as well. So it's possible the person abused the cooling system or the engine and he rendered it, you know, messed up the engine. So maybe your engine camshaft or crankshaft are already rubbing, going, you know, friction, hitting here and there. So it's possible it's coming from there too, you know. However, I do know that most people don't do take AC compressor and the what's it called, power sealing pump for granted, thinking that such things don't make, they do. When you remove the auxiliary belt, what you do is just go under the car, or you can do it from the engine bay, you know, when you open the bonnet, use your hand, because the belt is no longer there, and the AC compressor pulley is now free. You know, it has not the clutch to the compressor itself, so it's free. All you need to use your hand and spin it. If the pulley bearing on that compressor is bad, you will know okay, this is where the noise is coming from. So just spin it. If it's bad, you make it whoa as it's spinning, you know. Likewise, the power sealing pump can also be noise, can also make this kind of noise. But power sealing pump usually show itself when, even when you start the car, as you are turning the steering, you could hear the noise get louder, or it depends, or louder, or you know, lesser noise. You can tell from the steering that where the noise is coming from. But power sealing pump can make that, can be very noisy. The AC compressor pulley, the bearing that you know, joins the pulley and to the compressor itself, even though it's generally the same thing, you know, compressor, whether the pulley is part of the compressor, but whatever that join the bearing that joins the pulley to the main body of the compressor can fail. And once it fails, start the engine and the crankshaft pulley start spinning, the AC compressor pulley, the noise will come from there, can become very loud. So all these things, I believe you can now isolate all those noises. But if you checked all these attachments on the engine that I've mentioned, and none of them is making the noise, but you could hear the noise coming right inside the engine, and it's not from the timing chamber, my advice is look for another engine. Because if it's coming from your camshaft, your engine is done. What usually happens is if you accelerate very, very high, it becomes very bad. The noise will get bad. The thing is, I don't even know what the noise sounds like. Because if it's from the engine, if it's on the camshaft, that one is even completely different. It doesn't even sound like a one bearing. It's on its own. The kind of noise that comes from there is different. If from the crankshaft, you will know. In fact, you will even feel, you won't even suspect anything from that timing chamber, because that one is on low RPM. You may not hear the noise, or it may not be that loud. But once you push the RPM probably beyond 3,000 to up to 4,000 RPM, wow, you can't even stand the noise. You know that something is, it's as if something is grinding inside the engine. That's how the noise can be. So I hope this video helps. And like you said, you are in Kenya or from Kenya, so I don't know which, but since here in Nigeria, if you have said you are from Nigeria, I would have said, oh, probably it's EW engine, since from the pictures you sent, I didn't see VC's badge on the 406, so it's likely a four-cylinder engine. But over there in Kenya, maybe you guys also use diesel Peugeot cars, which we don't do here. You only find one or two on the road. So it's possible yours is diesel. And if it's diesel, I don't really know much about HGI engines. So I wish you the best in trying to fix your engine issues. All right. Thanks for watching.